All right, it's time to start working on the world's nastiest chisel. So I want to get, first of all, I just want to get as much of this old construction adhesive and rust off as I can. And I know people are going to go, why are you using your knife? Well, I don't really mind because I can resharpen my knife. So. And it's such excellent steel that construction adhesive. I buy a new Swiss champ about every 6 years because I use this thing so much that I'll sharpen the blade away to where it's into the finger pullout, so I have to get a new one. And then I just give the old one to friends and they keep it in their toolbox because all the other tools are still good on it. Yeah, I've looked at the Leatherman and all the other things and they don't do what this does in one compact unit. That's good enough for us to start grinding on it. Get it cleaned up. I'm going to use this 4x24 belt sander to clean the majority of the facets on this tool real quick. And it's got a nice new 120 grit aluminum oxide belt in it, so it should just do it in just a matter of minutes. So let's just get on with it. I want to check that I'm grinding it nice and flat. So this obviously was not flat, but it's not bad. It's a little pitted up here. I don't know if we're going to be able to grind all that pit out, but I'm going to try. I'm gonna get a little tub of water. It's hot, but it's not too hot for me to touch, but I definitely want to keep this blade cool so we don't damage the steel. Let me get some water. All right, that's good. Let's look at as we're grinding, let's just make sure that we keep our angle. See, I can tell you this was a new chisel when it was lost, because no one had ever worked on this thing before, because that's right at 25 degrees. So we're gonna have to take off some material because this end is so damaged. So not only am I gonna take this off, but I'm gonna have to come back on this heel a little bit too. I'm staying right there. I'm almost getting rid of, man, they must have hit this thing with into hardened steel screws or something to make, you know, those were 3/16 of an inch off that edge, as deep as those gouges were. Pretty good. I got one little microscopic piece of little chip still that I got to get out, and it's just a little whisper. I think I still need to get it out here on the belt sander. This belt probably has just enough life left in it to do it, but that's not looking too bad for being so disgusting. Okay, I think I can take care of the rest of that with the stones, and I'll clean this up with some paper. Clean the rest of this, make this bright, and